kind of bad for forcing my family to eat all the stuff I make, so today I made a personal pizookie. You're gonna need 2 tablespoons of melted butter, a tablespoon of light brown sugar, a tablespoon of granulated sugar, and 1 teaspoon of vanilla extract, 1/4 cup of flour, 1/8 teaspoon of baking soda, pinch of salt. Mix everything together, add some chocolate chips, put it in your ramekin. Then you're gonna preheat the oven to 375 and bake that for about 15 to 18 minutes. I added some ice cream and it was so good.
I'm a buff baby, but I dance like a man.
Like a man.
She a nice lady and she shaking her yams. Spent the whole summer trapping out the sedan. Marching with the band, 13 hours till I land. Happy.
1 cup of brown sugar, 1 cup of peanut butter, 1 large egg, 1 teaspoon of baking soda, 1/2 cup of chocolate chips. Mix it all together. Divide into 12 and place on a prepared baking sheet at 350 for 8 to 10 minutes. Boom.
On this episode of Cooking with Ali, here's a melt-in-your-mouth 60-second brownie in a mug. It literally requires 4 ingredients that you should already have in your pantry. If you do not have these ingredients, I'm so sorry. Please don't go to the grocery store because you need to be social distancing. But if you have all 4 of these ingredients, follow this recipe. It literally takes 60 seconds, and then you can get fat from it, because who cares if you get fat during quarantine season because you have an excuse, you know, stress eating. We love to stress eat. So enjoy. Let me know what I should make next because I'm running out of ideas.
First, you'll start with 5 frozen bananas, a little vanilla creamer, a little bit of almond milk, and voila. For the cookie dough, you'll need brown sugar, butter, flour, and vanilla, and some chocolate chips. You'll mix all that together, make some little balls, and it's time to make the blizzard.
Can't decide between cookies or brownies? Why not have both? I'm gonna preheat the oven first so that it's ready by the time I'm done prepping everything. I'm gonna start with the brownie mix, just adding the necessary ingredients and then whisking it all together until it's nice and smooth. Then I'm gonna do the cookie dough mix, adding again the necessary ingredients, and then I'm gonna use my hands to knead it together until a nice dough forms. I'm gonna spray the dish over the sink, that way it just makes less of a mess for me to clean later. I'm gonna add the brownie mix to the pan first, and then I'm just gonna make little balls of cookie dough and spread it sporadically. I usually do like a spoonful, and then I'm gonna add it to the oven. I usually do it for less time than it says on the box, just because I don't like it too overcooked. And then I'm just gonna check that it's ready, and then you have the best dessert ever. Ugh, with ice cream, yes!
This ooey gooey cinnamon pull apart bread is so good and so easy to make. Get yourself some biscuits. I use these because it was 58 cents on sale. Preheat your oven, cut the biscuits into pieces, a whole bunch of sugar and cinnamon in a bowl, mix it together, and you're going to dip the pieces in it and then lay it into a pan, okay? Pour some melted butter and remaining sugar on top, bake for 15 minutes, and you're done.
We're making 3-ingredient homemade Italian ice. First, combine 1/2 cup of sugar and 1/2 cup of water.
Bring to a boil, then down to a simmer until all the sugar is dissolved and the liquid is completely clear. This is what we call a simple syrup. You're gonna take it off the heat and let it cool to room temperature. Now into the blender goes 3 cups of frozen fruit. I'm using cherries, you can also use strawberries. Then we add our simple syrup, 2 tablespoons of fresh lemon juice,
and blend.
Pour into a container.
Look at that gorgeous color. Now this goes into the freezer for about 2 hours.
After 2 hours, give it a nice mix so the sugar doesn't settle to the bottom.
Now back in the freezer until it's frozen solid and ready to eat.
The world's easiest snack to make while you're home quarantined with only 3 ingredients, chocolate, some boiling heavy cream, into here, mix that together, and we are making chocolate truffles. They're literally the easiest thing on earth. Once you mix up 1 cup of the chocolate chips and 1/4 cup of the boiling heavy cream, let it sit for a few minutes so it can melt the chocolate. Once it melts, you're gonna start mixing it together. Now, it's gonna look like it's not gonna come together and it's like chocolate milk, but be patient, because it will. Once you have the super thick chocolate ganache transferred into a container that you can place in the fridge to let it harden. And place in the fridge. Scoop out a nice chunk of your chocolate ganache and use the heat of your hand that are washed, obviously, to form it into a ball. Drop it in any type of topping. I like to use sprinkles to fully coat and repeat. And bam, there you go. A little chocolate truffle, three ingredients, super easy. Let's give it a try. Look at that. Wow, it is super easy, super chocolatey. It's going to be your new favorite snack. Use only three ingredients. Go give it a try. Click that plus button for more recipes.
Because I'm still a virgin, I call this premarital hand-holding in a pan. This recipe calls for minimal ingredients. Here's me struggling to plop some graham crackers in a blender because I don't have a food processor. Toss them crackers up. Add half a cup of sugar and 6 tablespoons of melted butter. Use a fork to mix this because it will not blend. Grease that pan down and then put the graham cracker mixture on. I use Ghirardelli because I'm bougie, but honestly any brownie mixture works. And then pour it on top. Prepare it in the oven according to the box recipe. Pull the brownies out and change that oven to broil. Sprinkle on some marshmallows, and then I found these really cute goldfish graham crackers that I thought would really make it look cool, like they're swimming in a sea of marshmallows. And here's the final product. I kind of burnt it, but honestly it's still sexy.
No baked peanut butter bars. 1 cup of creamy peanut butter. 1 cup of unsalted butter. Mix. Add 2 cups of powdered sugar and mix. Add 2 cups of graham cracker crumbs, one at a time. Add tin foil into a 9x13 Purex dish. Press the batter into an even layer in the dish. Into a microwave-safe bowl, add a 12-ounce package of chocolate chips and 1/4 cup of peanut butter. Melt it. Pour it over the batter and spread evenly. Refrigerate for 1.5 hours. Slice. No baked peanut butter bars.
Today we're making 2-ingredient banana ice cream. Start off with 2 bananas.
Open them up and cut into discs.
How do you open a banana? Like this, from here? You know how I do it? I like to cut it. Like that. Perfect every time.
Now add your sliced bananas on a baking sheet with parchment paper as one single layer.
Now freeze these until they're nice and solid, about 2 hours. Pull your frozen bananas out of the freezer.
Add them to a food processor. About 2 tablespoons of milk or about 8 tiny spoons.
And puree this until it becomes an ice cream.
Make sure you scrape down the sides. And if you notice it's too dry like this is, add a little bit more milk. This is what it looks like. At this point, you can dish it up just as it is. If you want your ice cream harder, all you have to do is dish it into a freezer safe dish, put it in the freezer for a little bit. For the taste test, let's try it with our tiny spoon.
How to make French toast cookies. You're gonna start off with 1 stick of room temperature butter, 1/3 cup of sugar, 1/2 cup of brown sugar, 1 egg yolk, 1/2 cup of light corn syrup, 2 teaspoons of vanilla extract, and 1 teaspoon of maple syrup, and mix. Now for your dry ingredients, you wanna add 2 1/3 cup of flour, 1 teaspoon of cinnamon, 1 teaspoon of baking soda, 1/4 teaspoon of salt, and a little bit of nutmeg. Go ahead and fold your ingredients in. Now prep your pan. After you're done rolling your dough balls, go ahead and roll them in sugar before you add them to your pan. Like so. Bake at 350 for 10 to 12 minutes. And there you go. French toast cookies.
I'm making double chocolate fudge brownies and I'm melting down 1 cup of butter along with 2 1/4 cup of white sugar. Once it melts, take off the heat, adding 1 1/4 cup of Dutch cocoa powder, 1 teaspoon of salt, 1 teaspoon of baking powder, and 1 tablespoon of vanilla. 4 eggs cracked in 1 at a time. It should look like this. Now add in 1 1/4 cups of all-purpose flour. I'm adding a bag of semi-sweet chocolate chips. Mixing it together and putting it into my grease pan at 350 degrees for 1 hour. Next, I'm cutting, and here you go, some double chocolate brownies.